Hello and welcome to the Walt NPA YouTube channel. Off to the side of the road, just switching batteries one last time before I head home. You know, I just got done visiting my brother. And on the way home, I took a route that I used to take back when I first started learning to ride. It was one of the early routes that I would go to all the time. And it was kind of fun. I'm a nostalgic person. I like kind of doing things like that that remind me of good times. They make me smile. Anyway, I thought, you know what? I'm so close to Douglasville. I should just swing by and ride one of the early routes that I used to take all the time back when I was learning on my Suzuki GS450. That's what today's episode is going to be. It's going to reminisce a little bit about riding, you know, getting started all those years ago. Of course, there's been a 10-year gap from then until I started riding again, but we've already been over that story. All right, let's hit it.
Yo, this is Quiet Man from South Philly, PA, and you're watching Walton, PA, repping the Keystone State. Ride safe.
All right, as I said, we're here in Douglasville. It's a little town in Berks County, not too far from Montgomery County. This is where my family moved after we moved out of Philly. We came out here to Berks County for a life that had fewer people on Kensington Avenue shooting up heroin. And it was actually quite a fun place to be, even though I did resist it for a long time. So anyway, I got my license, or I took the MSF course, and then immediately bought myself, as I said, a Suzuki GS450 from a place not far from here at all. Actually, I could probably walk there from here. And at the time, I was living at home with my parents, had my awesome new hog, and I would ride it through the development just to kind of get a feel for what it was like to ride. And you know, I felt safe here in the development because, you know, speeds are fairly low. Generally, people are, I don't know, paying a bit more attention because they're looking for, you know, kids out playing and dogs and that sort of thing. So I always felt a little safer. Now I realize that some of these rides are going to get, some of this route is going to get a little repetitive, but I'm going to show you what I used to do. So I'd come down here. This is Lake Drive in Amity Township. Make a right here. This is just a big, just a loop around more of the development. Now back then, you know, the bike had the stock exhaust on it, but that wasn't good enough. Like I wanted something with a little grumble, a little mean streak. So I remember using, I don't know, it must have been like a 3/8 drill bit. And I drilled a bunch of holes in the plate for the muffler, and it made it growl a little more aggressively. I mean, it was still a little 450. It was kind of comical, but you know, I thought it gave it a meter sound. And then I remember my brother saying, "You know what? I'm pretty sure the Honda he bought a parts bike to repair this Honda 350 that he had that belonged to my father." He said, you know, I'm pretty sure that the exhaust, I think the hard exhaust or something like that, will fit on your Suzuki. He said, it'll be a lot louder. So, oh yeah, baby, let's do it. So I put that other exhaust on there, and of course it's much, much louder. And now I'm like roaring through the neighborhood. I'm sure the neighbors hated me back then, because I would just do lap after lap after lap until I felt comfortable to go on the bigger streets. So now, that road where I just turned would go back and double back on where I was. And that's kind of what I would do. I'd go back through there, and then I'd kind of weave my way through the development some more because it goes up a little ways. But when I started gaining a little more confidence, I'd come out here, which is Old Airport Road. So I'd be a little nervous, you know, because cars up here off of 422 and they'd be moving a little bit, and this was the big deal. I remember being a little nervous coming up here. you know, doing 40 miles an hour, 45 miles an hour for the first time. But as it turns out, I used to take this road non-stop because there's a turn up here and I absolutely loved it, this bend. And I would ride it in one direction and I'd spin around and I'd come ride the other direction. And then sometimes I would loop back through the development so that I could just keep coming back and riding this same section over and over again because it was so much fun. And it's it right here. You know, and I've never been a really aggressive rider, so, you know, leaning the bike over real far is comical. You know, that if you've ever seen that meme, you know, your kickstand leans the bike more than you do. I fit that meme. I feel like I own that. But yeah, I would come through here and I would do this bend, and it was the greatest thing. I'd ride it and ride it and ride it. And then you could take this road back here and it would loop back around. And you could do the whole thing all over again. Go through the development, come out there, do that S-bend. And then there's another road down here. It's been so long since I've been on it that I'm not entirely sure where it is or where it goes. But there is a road somewhere back here coming up on the left that I had to be careful with because it connects out to 422. So I had to like keep an eye on where I was and make sure I would have to make sure I turned at the right spot so that I didn't wind up on the highway. So anyway, yeah, we come back here. God, it's been years since I've been back here. You know, this also kind of a slow pace riding, but it was more scenic. You know, there's cornfields over here, you've got hedges and stuff. The houses are a little more secluded, and I remember coming through here for the first time with my Honda pipes on my Suzuki, making all kinds of racket. And this was another one of those roads where I would run it one way and then spin around and come back the other direction sometimes, because it does have a little, you know, some S curves. And even now, I mean, it's fun. It's nothing technical, nothing complicated. It's just fun little ride through these backcountry roads. I'm still, you know, it's been a long time and I'm still getting a kick out of swinging the bike from one side to the other. Oh man, I am so nostalgic. Oh man, some of this is just coming back to me. I remember, you know, riding down here like it was yesterday. Yeah, and then this is Limekiln Road, and I didn't make a right. And there was another series of bends that I really liked down here. This was the road I took just a few minutes back when I was coming home from my brother, or when I was coming back from my brother's house. And I was getting kind of nostalgic coming up to these bends here, because I remember doing the same thing. I'd get so excited and feel like hot stuff. Yeah, I'd lean my bike over 2 or 3 degrees. Go around this bend. This road's a lot more bumpy than I remember. Probably just years of use and repaving and whatnot. But yeah, there'd be another bend here, and then there's another bend right out here. And it was just so much fun back then. And of course, it was a smaller bike. You had to make it work harder to do what this bike does effortlessly. So, you know, it would sound like the bike was screaming, but you wouldn't really be moving anywhere. You know, it's not like you were flying through these bends at, you know, 30, 40, 50 miles an hour. But that little 450, man, it would scream with those exhaust pipes. And it was the coolest thing. You know, I have mixed emotions about that bike. It was like a great introduction to get into motorcycling. And there are times when I definitely miss it. And then I remember all the times that I spent like screwing around with the carburetors or fixing this or fixing that just so that I could go out for a ride. So like on one hand, I almost want to get another one just for nostalgia's sake. I don't want the one back that I had. Whoever owns that now can keep it. But I think it would be kind of cool to find another one. Although, I'd imagine they're getting harder and harder to come by. You know, an 80-something motorcycle in decent condition, I would imagine, would be either hard to find or expensive because of how old it is. You know, coming up on 40 years old. You know, that's hard. That makes me feel so old. You know, like, I was out a couple months back, and I remember getting on the Route 100, which is a popular thoroughfare. I remember seeing like an IROG Z Camaro with like vintage tags on it or something like that. And it was like, oh no, because that was, those cars were awesome. I wanted one so bad. And it's got like an antique plate on it. Oh, it's sickening. Nothing to make you feel old like seeing the car you liked as a kid have, you know, antique plates on it. Vintage, antique. So anyway, here's where I would kind of start to loop back home and make a right. And that would take me back towards Douglasville or Amity Township. But since we're on our way home, I'm going to go this way, head out to 562. Eventually, this was something that I started to explore too, kind of getting it out here. This was a little more... A little more scenic, a little more countryside. This takes you back into, I guess, the direction of Oley, which has a bit more farmland. What do I want to do? Make a right and go home, back toward Boyertown. This is not a great intersection. This will definitely take me back in toward Oley. I'm feeling nostalgic and stuff. I want to keep going. This is another road I used to ride. I used to come back here and I would look around and I would see these houses and they were really amazing. Like that house back there, that old truck out front, all this space. I remember seeing these houses and thinking like, this is what I want. It's like, at some point in my life, I'd love to own a home that was just plopped in the middle of lots of land with just open space around it, or woods on one side of it, kind of a thing. And I would come here, and I would think like, oh man, this is where the rich people must live. Some of these houses are really nice. What I really should do is go home, but I really don't want to. Oh wow, I just looked at the time. It's after 10. I've been out for 4.5 hours. They're coming up on 4.5 hours. I left the house at like 6 o'clock this morning. Yeah. As much as I want to go straight and ride off into the, you know, ride into some more backcountry roads, I really better get home. I have a feeling my wife's not going to be too pleased with my my motorcycle escapades today. So, I realized that this has been an awkward, not so much awkward, but a strange little video taking you down memory lane. But I had a lot of fun. It was nostalgic. Made me smile. And I kind of found, I don't know, maybe in a couple of new routes to take to kind of relive some of those memories from time to time. So, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please click on the subscribe button down below so you can get more content, just like this. You can also click on the notification bell and you'll get an alert anytime I publish a new video. Thank you for everything, for all the comments, the support, the positivity. It's made this whole motovlog journey a lot of fun, and I really appreciate it. So, with that said, as always, ride safe, and I will catch you in the next one.